Hey guys, it's Laura. I thought I'd come on here and make a video about how I study my Bible and what kind of books I use to study my Bible. So maybe you can pick those books up because they really help me. And I hope that it helps you too. So I'll start with my Bible. It's an ESV Journaling Bible Interleaved Edition, and I really like this Bible because I'll show you why it's called Interleave. It you have scripture, and then you have a blank page where you can put notes down. And so I put washi tape and stickers and everything in my Bible. So that's my Bible. I really recommend this Bible, especially if you like to study the Bible and take notes. It gives you a lot of room to really explore and really make your Bible your own. And if you're artistic, like if you're into art, you could make art and put it in your Bible, and you don't have to cover up the words of the page. 'Cause one thing that God really convicted me was when I started Bible journaling was I'm not allowed to cover up the words on the scripture. So, 'cause God really convicted me of not doing that. So I'm not judging anybody who does that, but for me, God told me to not do that. So so it really gives you a lot of space and a lot of room to like do art and write down notes and really make your Bible your own. And I have the Holman Illustrated Bible Dictionary, and this is really helpful. Like you look up words in the dictionary, and it has like maps, and you can find all these books on Amazon, and like pictures, and more maps, more pictures, and everything's in color, so it's just really nice. So I have that book. And I have that book. And then I have the Strong's Exhaustive Concordance of the Bible. This book is really helpful because you can look up a word and it gives you where the word is in the Bible. Like if I'm feeling anxious, I could look up anxious or anxiety, and it'll give you Bible verses on where to find it in the Bible. So it's, yep. And this has Greek in it and tells you what Greek words mean, and so it's really helpful to find things. It helped me do my divination video when I wanted to find Bible verses on divination. So I have that. I have the Worsby Bible Commentary. It comes in New Testament book and Old Testament book. I like Worsby Bible Commentary because it talks about like it the Bible in sections, and he gives you practical advice on like how to apply those sections to your life. It's not just straight commentary, so it's like this says Deuteronomy chapter 14. Verse 1 through 16, verse 17. And so that's how that is. And it's really helpful. these are not Catholic Bible commentaries. They're Protestant Bible commentaries. But they're really helpful for me to understand and study the Bible. So I have that, those two books, and the New Testament is the same as the Old Testament. And then I have, the Believer's Bible Commentary. This book is really helpful because it breaks the commentaries broken down verse by verse, so you can really get specific on a verse and get your commentary, and it asks you questions about like how to apply it to your life, and like what each verse means, and it's really helpful. And this is also another Protestant Bible commentary that I like to use. And I think that's it that I have to study the Bible. But every morning I look up on the scripture writing verses. I get the verse for the day, and then I write down the verse, and then I study that chapter that the verse is found in, and I'll get my Wordsby Bible commentary and my Believer's Bible commentary, and I'll read both of those, and then I'll write notes inside my Bible, and I do that every morning, and it's really helpful, and it really helps me to study the Bible and understand what's going on, because sometimes, like, it's like, I can read the Bible, and I kind of, sometimes I understand what's going on, but, the Bible commentaries really help me clarify scripture. So, and then I reread it, and I read it a couple times, read the scripture over, and it really just helps me absorb it and really, like understand and what's going on. The one thing I will tell you about the commentaries, this Believer's Bible Commentary doesn't really give you a lot of history, like dates and like who wrote who, and it gives you some history, but it doesn't really go into depth about the historical context. The Wordsby Bible Commentary gives a lot of history and gives dates and stuff. So if that's helpful to you, that's really helpful. And so that's what I do. And those are some of the books that I have and some of the books that I use to study my Bible. So I hope that's helpful. And Yeah, okay. Bye, guys. I love you. Bye.